Analytics is an important part of a website. Analytics can help you evaluate the performance of your website, can help you optimize your content so you can provide the most value to your users. In a previous video, I covered how to add a Google Universal Analytics property to your Gatsby site using Google Tag Manager. Since that video, Google has released a new version of Google Analytics. And so in this video, I want to show you how to add their new version, Google Analytics 4, to a Gatsby site using Google Tag Manager. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks from Guiding Digital. I'm going to be bringing you videos on this channel about website best practices. So if you're a developer, a marketer, or a small business owner wanting to refine your skills and get your content noticed, this channel is for you. And so subscribe below to stay informed about future content. Today, we're going to walk through adding Google Analytics to a Gatsby site. In this video, I use a new version of Google Analytics, Google Analytics 4. If you need an overview of Google Analytics 4, make sure and watch my previous video where I give you 7 things you need to know about the new version. Also, this video assumes that you're adding Google Analytics for the first time to your site. If you already have the previous version of Google Analytics on your site, Universal Analytics, I will be publishing a future video on how to upgrade your site to Google Analytics 4. When that is available, I'll put a link here and put the link in the video description. You may still find this video useful for upgrading, but if my video on upgrading is available, I would recommend switching to that video. There are 2 primary ways of adding a new Google Analytics 4 property to your Gatsby site. You can use a global site tag, or you can use Google Tag Manager. So which method should you use? If you have a basic site and all you want is Google Analytics on your site, then using a global site tag is probably the simplest method to use. However, if your site is more complex, in addition to Google Analytics, you need to install other marketing tags and other custom Google Analytics events, then I would recommend using Google Tag Manager. In this video, I'm going to cover how to install Google Analytics using Google Tag Manager. In a previous video, I covered how to add Google Analytics 4 to a Gatsby site using a global site tag. And so I'd recommend switching to that video if that is the method you plan on using. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is to create the Google Analytics 4 property. To do that, we'll go to analytics.google.com, and we'll be presenting with one of 2 different pages. If you've never created a Google Analytics account, you'll see this welcome page. To get started, click the Setup for Free button to go to the Account Setup Wizard. If you already have an account for another website, it will take you to the home dashboard for your existing property. To add a new account, click on the admin link at the bottom of the left navigation, and then from there, you can add a new property to your existing account or create a new account. For this video, I'm going to create a new account so we can see the entire process, and so I'll click the Create Account button. On the first screen, enter the account name and then your data sharing settings. I'm going to be stingy and not send Google any additional information by unchecking all of the boxes, and then I'll click the Next button. I'll enter a property name and select my time zone. If you click on the Show Advanced Options button, it gives you an option to create a Universal Analytics property. Universal Analytics is the previous version of Google Analytics. Their new version, Google Analytics 4, has been the default version now for several months. But if for some reason you still need to create a property using the previous version, you can do so by clicking this toggle. You then have a choice of creating both a Google Analytics 4 and a Universal Analytics property, or only a Universal Analytics property. For most cases, in my opinion, there's no need to use this option and create a Universal Analytics property. If you're adding Google Analytics to your website for the first time, then go ahead and use the new version. The only exception is that some third-party services that integrate to websites may not support Google Analytics 4 yet. If this does apply to you, I would recommend keeping the default option of creating both property types so you can at the very least be building up your history in the new version. For this demo, we're just going to create a Google Analytics 4 property, and so we'll toggle this option off and click the Next button. On the next screen, we'll choose our industry category, business size, and indicate our purpose for using Google Analytics. All the options on this screen are optional. We'll then click the Create button to create our property, and then read through the terms if you'd like. Click the checkbox and click the I accept button. Next, we need to add one or more data streams to our property. One new feature in Google Analytics 4 is that you can collect data from apps and your website in the same property to get a unified view. For today, we are just focused on our Gatsby website, and so we'll choose the web option and then enter our website URL and give our stream a name. Another nice feature of Google Analytics 4 is that if you use the enhanced measurement feature that is displayed here, then the Google Analytics script will automatically collect additional measurements such as scrolls, outbound links, and file downloads. In the previous version, you had to implement custom solutions to track these events. If for some reason you don't want to track any of these additional items, you can go to the settings and turn them off. There is also a setting we need to adjust here for the page view items to avoid duplicate page views being sent. Gatsby sites under the cover are really single page applications, meaning that as you navigate through a website, the entire payload for the page is not being sent to the browser for each request. Under the covers, Gatsby is updating the page to simulate a new page. For the end user, the website behaves just like any other website, but the fact that the page is not reloaded each time causes issues for solutions like Google Analytics. In previous versions of Google Analytics, the script that Google Analytics gives you to add to your site assumes that the script will be executed each time a user navigates to a new page on your site. And so since this isn't the case for single page applications, you have to add additional code that will manually send a page view event to Google Analytics each time a user navigates to a new page. The plugin we'll be adding to our Gatsby site later in the video takes care of this additional work for you. However, in Google Analytics 4, if you choose to enable enhanced measurements, Google has added a new feature that will send page view events on browser history events. Browser history events are fired in Gatsby whenever a user navigates to a new page. If we leave this setting as is, this will result in duplicate page views being sent each time a user navigates to a new page. To correct this, we need to go into the advanced setting for page views and uncheck the checkbox for page changes based on browser history events. For our demo, we'll leave all the rest of the enhanced measurement items enabled and click the Save button. We'll then hit the Create Stream button to create our stream. Our Google Analytics property is now set up. For now, I'll leave this window open. We'll need to come back to this screen later to copy the measurement ID that is assigned to us. Next, we need to create our Google Tag Manager account. To do that, in a new browser tab, we'll navigate to tagmanager.google.com and then click the Create Account button to start the Create Account wizard. On the first screen, we'll enter an account name, select the country if needed, and then enter a container name. I usually use the URL of my website for the container name as they suggest. Then we'll need to select web as the target platform and then click the create button. On the next screen, read through the terms of service agreement if you would like, and then click the GDPR acceptance checkbox, and then click the yes button in the upper right to accept the terms. Our container is now created. This install Google Tag Manager dialog gives us the script to place on our site if we were manually placing it on our site. In our case, we'll be using the Gatsby plugin, and so all we need is this container ID. We'll come back later to copy the ID once we have Tag Manager configured. For now, you can close this dialog. Now we need to add a new tag for our Google Analytics 4 property. To do that, click on the Add a New Tag link. There are two pieces to each tag, the configuration and the trigger. The configuration is what will be delivered to our website, and the trigger is the event that will determine when or if the tag is placed on our site. Let's first select our configuration. Click on the configuration section to open up the tag type selection window. In our case, we want to implement Google Analytics 4 on our site, and so we'll choose the Google Analytics GA4 configuration type. Next, we'll need to enter our measurement ID for our Google Analytics web stream that we set up in the previous step. And so we'll switch to our first browser tab and copy the measurement ID, and then switch back to Tag Manager and paste it in the measurement ID field. We'll leave the checkbox checked to send a page view when the configuration loads. Now we need to tell Tag Manager when to fire the event by selecting a trigger. We'll click on the triggering section to open the Choose a Trigger dialog. When the dialog first loads, the only trigger available is All Pages. Don't select this one. We'll need to add a custom event instead. If we were to use this one, the configuration would load the first time when we went to our site, but wouldn't fire as the user navigated through the site because of how we previously said that single page applications work. To add a custom event as a trigger, click the plus sign in the upper right, and then click on the trigger configuration box to select a trigger type. In our case, the plugin that we will be using fires a custom event for on-route change events. The on-route change event is fired each time a user navigates to a new page, and so we need to select custom event as our trigger type. Now we need to enter the name of the custom event that the plugin will fire. The plugin allows you to name the event whatever you'd like, but we'll just use the default name it gives us. To find the default event name, let's open the plugin's documentation page. We'll do that by opening a new tab and going to the gatsbyjs.com site and going to the plugins section and then searching for tag. The plugin we'll be using should be the first one on the list, Gatsby Plugin Google Tag Manager. We'll click on the item to open up the details view, and then scroll down to the section on tracking routes. There you'll find the name of the custom event, Gatsby Route Change.
copy that event name, and go back to Google Tag Manager and paste it in the event name field, and then hit the Save button. We'll name our trigger Gatsby Route Change Trigger and hit the Save button again. Then we'll save our tag and we'll just keep the default name it gives it and hit Save one more time. Changes that you make in Tag Manager don't automatically get pushed out to your live site, and so you'll need to hit the Submit button to publish your changes. Then on the Submit Changes window, you can add notes about what changed in the new version you are publishing. In our case, we'll just enter initial GA for setup and click the Publish button to publish the changes to our container. Now we need to configure our Gatsby website to add our new Google Tag Manager container. As a starting point, I've created an out-of-the-box Gatsby site that was created using the Gatsby new command. The first thing we need to do is add a plugin to our Gatsby site that will implement the Tag Manager container. And so I'll open up a terminal window within Visual Studio Code. I'll go back to the plugin's documentation page for the implementation details. I'll then scroll back up to the install section and either copy the entire command if you're using npm as your dependency manager, or copy the plugin name if you're using Yarn. I'm using Yarn as my dependency manager, and so I'll just copy the name. I'll then switch back to Visual Studio Code, and in the terminal window, type yarn add, and then paste in the plugin name, and press enter to add the plugin. Next, we need to add the plugin to the Gatsby config file's plugins array. And so I'll open the Gatsby config file. I'll then go back to the plugins documentation page and go to the how to use section and copy everything between the opening and closing curly braces as a starting point. I'll then switch back to Visual Studio Code and I'll add the config at the top of the plugins array. Now let's go through the config options that are included. The first option is the ID for your Google Tag Manager container. We'll switch back to Google Tag Manager. And the easiest way to copy the ID is to click on the ID in the header, and then you can copy it from the installation dialog. Then switch back to Visual Studio Code and paste the ID in the config. The next option indicates if you want to load the container for development builds. Since we don't want testing data sent to Google Analytics, we'll keep this set to false. Next, you can set the data layer name and add additional configuration for various environments. The default data layer name might be useful to set if you were adding customizations, and environment details are a good way to preview changes that you make in Tag Manager. For this demo, we are just setting up a basic installation, and so we're going to delete both of these sections. The last item is where you can change the name of the custom event name that is fired on route change. We've already configured Tag Manager to listen for the default event name, Gatsby Route Change, and so we'll delete this setting as well. We'll also delete the comments just to clean it up a little. You'll see that the basic install has a very simple configuration. Our site is now configured and ready to test. First, let's save our changes, and then we need to open our site in production mode since we set the include and development option to false. To do that, we'll run a Gatsby build command to build our site for a production build, and then run a Gatsby serve command to view our site. We can hold down the control key and click the link in the terminal to open the site. I'm going to open the site side by side with the Google Analytics and Google Tag Manager and give as much room as possible to those tabs. To verify that Tag Manager is set up correctly, we have several options. The first is the preview function in Google Tag Manager. Ideally, we would have done this before we published in case there were issues that needed corrected, but it still works after publishing as well. To use the preview function, click on the preview button in the navigation bar, and then enter the URL of the site you want to verify, in this case, our localhost site that we have open on the right. And so just copy and paste the URL from the localhost site, then hit the start button. This will open up our site in a new window, which I'll also move to the right. Click the Continue button and then you can click around on your site to see that the tag is being fired. You can get more details by clicking on the Google Analytics ID at the top and see that it is sending a page view on each click as expected. We can click on the item to view the details of the page view. The next method of verifying our data is by examining the data within Google Analytics. If we go to the home dashboard, the only real-time data we see is the number of users in the last 30 minutes. We do see that there was one user, and so that's a good sign. The rest of this data on this page is delayed by about a day, and so it's not very useful in verifying your initial setup. You can also go to the real-time page. This page gives us a more detailed view of the data, and the data is only delayed by about 10 to 20 seconds, and it shows the data from the last 30 minutes. We see several page view events, and so that seems to match up with what we were expecting. Another way, and in my opinion the best way within Google Analytics, when your goal is to verify a new implementation, is the debug view page. You can find a link to the page at the bottom of the Google Analytics navigation menu. Since we have already connected the debugger to the page by visiting Tag Manager first, we already see data when we initially visit the page. If we click around on the page again, we see that the events show up in about 10 seconds. You can click on an event to see the details and examine the individual properties of the event. The last thing I'll show you is how Google Analytics now tracks additional events. As I mentioned earlier, one of the new features of Google Analytics 4 is that it tracks events such as outbound link clicks without any additional coding as long as you have the enhanced measurements enabled. We left those enabled, and so we can click on a link such as this link to the gatsbyjs.com site. Then after a few seconds, we'll see the click event. We can examine the event, and we see that it is the event from the gatsbyjs.com link.
In today's video, we've added Google Analytics 4 to our Gatsby site using Google Tag Manager. In a future video, I'll show you how to upgrade a Gatsby site that currently uses Universal Analytics to Google Analytics 4. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like, and make sure to subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below, and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.